on downwind and you have to adjust it quickly, it's much easier to crack it off when it's closer to the cleat.
I usually like having it like maybe 2 inches to an inch and a half when it's fully tightened. It's really important to not have it also too long, because sometimes when you're sailing, it'll get stuck in here, and then when you're on your downwind and you have to fix it really quickly, you can't, because then it gets stuck. The second thing I like doing after I tighten my sprit halyard is to crack it back 3 or 5 times, then pull this to make sure it really gets locked up in there. From personal experience, I know what it feels like to be on your second upwind after your downwind and have it come out 10, 12 times. So it slows you down, so it's important to make sure you have this extra safety here that it's not gonna come out on the water. All right, a really special tip for on the water is to always carry around special sail tie, because eventually, once in a while, you'll have a sail tie that comes undone in the middle of that water, and that gap that gets created when that happens is not fast. So it is important to have sail ties, maybe one on like these bungees, maybe one at your back airbag, and it has to be tied on so you can easily access it. If you're at your coach boat at the end of the race and you realize, oh no, a sail tie came off, you need to be able to change it quickly. So what I like doing is I like moving it like this, putting it under this, and just pinching it like that. It won't come off if you capsize, and it's very easy to take off. All you have to do is pull this, and it's off, and it's easy to tie back onto your boot. It's very important to have extra sail ties at your access so you can replace them in case any of them fall off. Hope you can use these.